War. It's a horrible thing. My name is Henry. I am an American in the Italian army, and I drive the ambulance. My feelings towards the war are nothing personal at all. In fact, I have nothing to do with it. One day, my good friend Rinaldi asked me to meet a girl that he fancied named Catherine. I wasn't really interested in going at first, but he talked me into it. Well, me and her started walking, and I realized maybe she's not a bad girl after all.
So how do you do?
Fine, how are you?
I do, you don't look Italian.
No, I'm an American, but I drive the ambulance.
That's a bit old. To be in the Italian army and not being Italian.
No, not really.
Still old, though.
You know, not everything has an explanation.
Well, I was always thinking that everything had an explanation.
So, what's with the stick?
Yeah. Belonged to a boy who was killed in the Somme. He and I were engaged. He was quite lovely.
What a tragedy.
Yeah.
So, who's that over there?
Oh, that's Helen Ferguson, my friend. And Rinaldi, your friend, who thinks he has a chance with me. No shot there.
How sad. Gordini, we have to get this pasta and cheese to the other ambulance drivers. Are you ready? Let's go!
When we got word that the Germans would be attacking us soon, it really didn't faze me at all. Until I saw what they were bringing with them.
I can't believe we had a retreat from Caporetto. This will never work. Are y'all up for jumping ship with me, boys? I concur. Let's go. Let's go, boys. It's harvest time. Can't believe I got separated from the others.
Richiamo, Henry!
Oh no, I've been caught. Pepperoni.
You, mozzarella.
What do you want?
You're under arrest. Keep your hands up.
Hey, what's that?
After swimming about 2 million miles, it seemed, I caught up with Catherine and we ran away together. We met this barkeeper who was quite nice to us and let us borrow his boat to go across the river. Well, it was quite an interesting night.
Don't worry, darling. We will escape this dreadful war and live lives of our own. My arm's getting really tired here, darling.
Why don't you hold out the umbrella and catch some wind?
What a genius idea, that's why I love you. Whoa, Melling! We made it! Oh, gosh. What a smooth man. Freedom! Can you smell it? So much.
Oh, no, my son. No.
No!
Henry, how's the baby?
He'll pull through.
Okay.
I'm sorry, sir. Your baby's dead.
Don't mind that. Just rest, darling.
Promise me you won't say the words you've said to me to another woman.
I promise. No! It's not your time!
The priest, a friend of Henry's, is characterized by his ability to maintain faith in God alongside his cynicism with regard to the war. He often serves as a counselor to Henry, explaining to him the difference between love and lust, as well as the futility of the war.
Have you found Jesus?
Catherine Berkeley is an English nurse serving at the Italian front. She is characterized primarily by her disregard for social conventions as well as an unfaltering devotion to Henry.
I'm all natural.
Rinaldi, Henry's roommate, is a surgeon at the Italian front. Where the priest is concerned with higher values, Rinaldi seeks immediate pleasures and sensual relationships. Unlike Henry, he cannot deal with the knowledge of the futility of war and resorts to sex as a means to forget.
Baby, can I pour you a glass of wine?
Helen Ferguson is a friend of Catherine, but unlike Catherine, does not share her disregard for social conventions. She strongly disapproves of the love affair between Henry and Catherine, but ultimately chooses to help the lovers. Frederick Henry, an American ambulance driver and a lieutenant in the Italian army, is the narrator and protagonist of the novel. The focus of the novel revolves around his love with Catherine Berkeley, as well as his steady disillusionment with the war. Henry is characterized initially by a sort of detachment from life, though well-disciplined and friendly, he feels as if he has nothing to do with the war.
Bloodiest battle you will ever see in your life.
That's a bit off. We, the American and being the Italian army.
No, not really.
But I was right. Oh crap.
One more time.
It's like the people at the news anchors. Sorry about that. They're all, you know, like...
That's wonderful. Okay, let's go.
We're not putting it on. All right.
Well, it's already on there, so let's go.
Okay. Ready?
Yeah, whenever y'all are.
Doc? Ugh.
Quick question.
Ricciamo, Henry!
Mozzarella.
Pepperoni.
I guess I'm under arrest, huh?
Put your hands up. You're under arrest, you officer.
You arrested me. I was with my hands up. She cuffed me. Put your hands up.
Unique New York.
Y'all ready?
Oh crap.
Okay.
Woo! Alright.
Back door.
Alright. Come.
Okay.
God, I thought you
like, should I hop in her? You're like, good. Ha 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 ha!